Hi, I'm Chuck at Inline Tube, and today we're going to show you how to assemble your 1968 to 1972 GM A-body upper booster kit for your disc brake conversion. The booster comes from the manufacturer with two different pins. One short pin already installed in the booster, and one long pin that comes as an extra. The long pin is only for deep bore master cylinders. So for this application, we will be using the short pin since we have a shallow bore master cylinder. To install, just push in the hole as far as it will go and it will seat itself. The booster comes with the factory correct check valve with the grommet, and on the back, it comes with the dust boot for the firewall and the correct bolt pattern for a 1968 to 1972 GM A-body. We are now ready to attach the clevis that comes with the booster. You will want to screw the clevis to the rod, making certain to measure the distance from the old setup to the new setup. When you get it to the same distance, slide the nut so that it locks in place and cannot go any further. You will now take the pin and put it into the pedal assembly on the lower hole for power and upper hole for manual. Take the booster and feed the back through the firewall. Once through the firewall, the booster will sit on the four studs on the firewall. Finger tighten the nuts to secure the booster into place. Using a wrench, tighten all the nuts until the booster sits flush against the firewall. Next, you will want to grab the proportioning valve. Notice the little rubber boot on the end of the disc drum proportioning valve. If you don't see a rubber boot, then it will be a disc-disc valve. You can also identify both by the letters and number located on the side. PV2 is for disc drum, and PV4 would be for disc-disc. Now, place your proportioning valve on the proportioning valve bracket. This is the booster side, or master cylinder side. You want to make sure that you put the largest port facing the front of the vehicle. Then you will take the bolts and push them through on both. Flip it over and put your nuts on. Now you want to leave everything a little bit loose. You don't want to tighten anything so that you have room when you go to install. Now we are going to take the shortest 1/4-inch line and screw it into the valve. Again, finger tighten them loosely so that you have plenty of room. Next, take your smallest 3/16 line and screw that into the valve. Notice that the lines, when put into the master cylinder, will make an X. Before installing the master cylinder, you will need to bench bleed it completely to remove all of the air. Bench bleeding instructions are not covered in this video. To install the master cylinder, remove the nuts from the booster and attach the master. Make sure the master cylinder is fully seated and install the driver's side nut. Now, grab your bracket assembly and place it on the passenger side stud and finger tighten. Be certain to leave it loose so that there's room for adjustments. Bring the assembly up and attach the lines into the master cylinder. Finger tighten all the lines into place, then use your line wrench to snug all the fittings. We will not be showing the seating procedure in this video. For instructions, see how to properly seat a brake line. Notice how there is a gap between the two lines and they do not rub against each other. Now, finger tighten the bracket onto the valve with the two bolts, then complete it with the wrench. You can now tighten the master cylinder onto the booster and you are done. Here's an example of the line setup for DBU01. The left front line will connect to the proportioning valve on the driver's side angled port. This line runs from the valve down to the left front brake hose bracket. The right front line will connect to the valve on the passenger side to the smallest port. This line will run down across the engine crossmember to the right front brake hose bracket. Notice that the master cylinder lines make an X when installed correctly from the master to the proportioning valve. The front section of the front to rear line will have a large blue fitting and will connect to the front port of the proportioning valve and run down towards the firewall. This line will union to the front or rear line that feeds the back of the vehicle using a female-female connection. The last two lines included in the kit are the rear axle lines. These lines will run from the rear wheel cylinder to the rear T. Rear hose with T not included. As a reminder, Inline Tube has stainless brake line sets for your disc brake conversion. Contact us at inlinetube.com via the chat to find out which one fits your application.